So I've turned this in the orientation that it's going to be in, where our pipe is coming in here. So my bottom drain's coming in this way. So I have my fittings right here to do our bottom drain connection. And if you're not routined on this, let me just show you a trick here. Oftentimes I'll mark this out. That's where I want to be. And then I'll mark the center of this as well. So there's the center. Because you have this, I have this big hole saw bit. You might just double check before you go ahead and do the drill. Make sure you got the right size drill bit, because if you do the wrong size hole saw, it's kind of a pain. But I'm gonna take this hole saw off, because if you'll notice, when you go to, let me show you first here. If you go to mark this, it's kind of unclear. So oftentimes what I'll do is I'll take this hole saw off and I'll just pilot this hole real quick. So we'll get the pilot hole in. Now we can just push this right through. So once that comes through, I'll just deburr it a little bit with a razor. So I'm just gonna clean this up a little bit. It's a little dirty from throwing it in and out of the hole. I'll clean the inside and the outside before I go ahead and install the bulkhead. So here's my specialty fitting. This is the inside of the tank, and we have our washer right here. We want to make sure it's seated properly inside the groove for it. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to install a little bit of polyurethane on here just to help lock this whole thing in, and helps lock the threads in place too. Technically the polyurethane doesn't have to go on there, but it's just a little extra step. Now I don't need Teflon tape on these threads because the seal is on the inside of the unit with that polyurethane and the O-ring. But I'm gonna get a wrench on this and tighten it down. Okay, so now that I've got this on hand tight, I wanna get just a little more turn on it, and I wanna show you a quick little trick. This is a large pair of channel locks that we can use to tighten this, but this pair of channel locks is probably 80 to 100 bucks. I'll let Nick use that one on the inside. And I'm gonna show you this cool little tool. It's called a strap wrench. And you get this in the plumbing department, and they're only like maybe 15 or 20 bucks. So if you're doing something, hold on. If you're doing, you're not doing this professionally and you don't need a $100 pair of wrench, you can just use this to tighten it up. Are you ready for me?
Mm-hmm.
You tight? So, cool little tool I think you might find useful and save you probably 80 bucks. Okay, let's go ahead and get this in the hole and we'll get it leveled out, and then we can start plumbing back to the bottom drain. So I'm digging out just a little bit more right here, so I have a nice sweep from my pipe in my trench to tie into the bottom of this. So I'm gonna get this cleaned out. I'll drop this in place, get it leveled and backfilled. We've placed the settlement tank into the hole. I have it level from front to back and side to side. I want you to know we took great care in using this tamping tool to compact the floor of where the settlement tank's gonna be put. We don't want the settlement tank to settle after installation, of course. That would not be good. What's important for you to know is, at this point of the project, we obviously know where the water level of the pond is gonna be. We established the bond beam according to the water level of the pond, and we also wanted a client that wanted a 5-foot deep pond, so we were able to achieve that 5-foot depth because we know where the water level of the pond is. So when you install this, you need to take great care in making sure that the top of the settlement tank is 2 inches above water level. That way, when you put water into the pond starts to fill, the water is going to travel through the bottom drain, and it will end up 2 inches below the top of this guy here. So our water level is going to be right here. That's the water level of the pond. At this point, I'm prepared to run my plumbing down to the suction side of the settlement tank and get it ran back this way. And then I can do some backfill around here and get this thing nice and stable so we can do the plumbing that leads down to the bottom drain.